Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see how we can remove IPM without damaging IPM or without damaging the circuit board. It is a double-sided soldered from top side and bottom side. What are the easiest methods and how we can remove it safely? Let's start. If the IPM is already damaged, just cut the pins from both sides, remove the IPM, and then using soldering iron, heat up the pins and remove pin one by one. That is simple method. If you want to use desolder wick, that will not a good decision, because desoldering wick cannot suck the solder from the cylinder, because this is cylinder. Between cylinder there is pin, and around the pin between the cylinder there is solder, so that solder cannot be sucked by the soldering wick. We cannot use this brush. If we will use this brush, the solder droplets from here can make short circuit between any SMD component. A micro droplet of the solder can damage the board permanently, or we cannot blow the air. If we are heating up the pin and we are blowing air, that will cause to fly the solder droplets, and that can make short circuit in the board. The best option, you can use manual vacuum pump. It is also not a safe method, because when we are sucking and when we are lifting up, it can also drop the droplets on the board. Same way, if you have this balloon sucker, you can install in this soldering iron, and you can use this as well, because it is also vacuum sucker. Most safe method, that is using desoldering tool, that is vacuum based. It will heat up and it will suck the solder. In the first step, we need to clean the conformal coating. If we will desolder with conformal coating, this conformal coating will make problem during suction. It will choke the nozzle. You can use isopropyl alcohol thinner or any solvent which can remove the conformal coating. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah yusallimak. Mashkur jiddan. This is my coffee. The second thing, that is soldering temperature, desoldering temperature. We must check the data sheet for allowed temperature for desoldering or soldering, and soldering time. How much temperature is allowed and for how much long time? For example, 410 degree for 3 seconds, 430 degree for 3 seconds, like that. Normally I use 435 degree for desoldering IPM and these power components. The next thing, that never desolder or solder in one line. For example, if I am starting from here, I will not continue in the same line. I will divide in parts, one here, one here, one here, one here. So we will allow a cool down time for the last pin. When we will desolder this, then we will start here, then we will reach back here, this will cool down. Otherwise, if we will work in one line, it will cause to damage the component, because in that specific area the chip temperature can increase and its internal connections may melt, so that component may damage permanently. Now I will touch the solder to all pins, and we will melt the solder for good thermal conductivity. And if there is any oxide, if there is any carbon material, or there is any deposit, that will burn out. If the board has double side conformal coating, so remove the conformal coating from second side as well. Otherwise, when we will suck the solder from here, the second side layer will not allow to pass the air. So vacuum will not work properly. You can use freeze-it spray to spray on the component body so that it will not heat up. That is also a very good point of safety for the component when we are desoldering or soldering. We will check all the pins by moving. If there is any solder, we will desolder it. We will apply some solder and desolder it again. Now we will apply a very little force in upward condition and we will monitor the pins. If any pin is stuck, we will retouch it again. So all the pins are safe and IPM is now out and all the tracks are good. Now we can see all the eyelets are good. There is no damage on any track or in eyelet in the second side. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.